Hey, how's it going? It's Doug, Grown in Faith Farm. I wanted to drop off a video today because we live off the grid and we use a lot of equipment, I guess you'd say. So we're going to start doing some reviews on some items that you would have, like footwear, handwear, socks, like our wood cook stove we could talk about. And we're just going to start doing some postings on some items and doing reviews on them, okay? So today what I'm going to talk about are the Muck boots, all right? The Muck boots are pretty popular. A lot of people wear them. The Amish wear them a lot. And I get a pair. I've gotten one pair every year for the last couple of years. So to me, they're basically a 1 year boot. And I'm going to show you some things going on with the Muck boot and let you make your decision. But for myself, I don't think I'm going to purchase Muck boots anymore because A, I only get 1 year use out of them. So I don't want to buy a pair of boots every single year. I use them heavy in the wintertime and I use them a little bit in the spring. And then other than that, I don't really use them. They're rated up to 40 degrees Fahrenheit, 4 degrees Celsius for comfort, I guess. And once you get out of spring and into summer and stuff, you really can't wear them too much because they're too hot. So I have been looking at Baffin. Baffin makes some boots. I'm going to do a review on some Baffin boots that I just got for winter wear. And then I'm also going to give their neoprene boot a shot and see if the Baffin is a better boot than the Muck boot. And I'm going to go over a few of the things on the Muck boot that the Baffin improves on. And I think that that would make the difference as far as durability for the boot. Okay? So my boots are dirty. I'm just grabbing the phone and was thinking about doing this, so I'm just doing it. These are the Muck boot. Okay, these are the Arctic Sport. They're supposedly durable and supposedly good for cold temperatures and comfortable. One thing I will say about the Muck boot is that it is comfortable. I won't say that it kept my foot warm all the time because it really didn't. And I wear smart wool socks in the wintertime, and I also wear cotton socks, which aren't really recommended for winter boot use because you want a sock that wicks away the moisture from your foot. Okay, but I do. I did wear cotton socks, and I do wear smart wool socks, and but my foot. I won't say that my foot was cold. But I will say that I felt the cold, if that makes sense to you. Okay? So my foot was never 100%, just snug and warm inside. All right? And that's all during the winter use. So these are the Arctic Sports after 1 year of use on the farm. I'm going to try to set this here and hopefully the lighting works out and everything else. All right. So one thing right here you can see. See that? That boot is coming apart right there. Okay? Now, on the toe here, you can see some problems with that coming apart. And I would give maybe that a pass because I'm working on the farm. I'm doing stuff all the time and I could kick stuff. And so I would be lenient on maybe at the toe area. But this right here, cracking right here, right there along that seam of the mold injection there should be no reason for that. That's not like me scuffing the boot or anything else. That is simply the product giving way, wearing out. Okay? And then you can see like the neoprene here is tearing, coming apart. And then right here you can see I'm trying to get that for you. You can see right here that there's a breach where the strap connects to the body molding. Okay? So the boot is coming apart in areas that are just giving way. And that's not good when you spend this kind of money on a boot. You want the boot to last, right? Now, this neoprene stuff, I mean I'm kind of I mess with barbed wire and stuff like that. I'm not saying I'm brushing up against it all the time or anything, but I could give this kind of a stuff a little bit of a pass. But when you see this kind of stuff right here, this boot coming apart right here, right where it connects into the back here, the strap connects into the back, and that this neoprene, this side here, where it's right at the injection molding site, that this is cracking open right there. You can see it. Okay, that's just straight up, you know, product flaws, and you know, it's just giving loose, giving way. Okay, now back here, you can't really see that. My boots are kind of dirty. Now another thing that's happening is right where the boot is glued or put together at the sole, it's coming apart. You see that? Okay, so. I won't be purchasing another pair of these boots, okay? And that's my right foot, and this is my left foot. Again, I have a part here where, you know, from walking, eventually the crease on the top of the boot has now caused a cavity here, a hole. And then here again, you can see that the boot is coming apart from the sole of the shoe, okay? Now that has nothing to do, this boot, you know, as you can see, is in a lot better shape physically. You know, it doesn't have the kick toe isn't destroyed or anything just from using it, but it's failing. The boot is failing in several areas, okay? There's another one right there where the boot is just coming. These boots are only 1 year old, okay? And I only wear them in the wintertime. I've had other boots before. I got a pair of Red Wings that I wear in the summertime. I've had them for 3 years, haven't even put a sole on them. And I'm much harder on my boots in the summertime than I am in the wintertime. Okay? So this is the review of the Arctic Sport boot, the Muck boot by the Muck boot. It's the Arctic Sport model. And, you know, I'm just trying to show you. If you're not, you know, if you're light on shoes, if you're an urban person, and you just throw some boots on every once in a while and maybe truck out to your car or that kind of a thing, you know, they're probably okay boots. You know, they're trendy looking and they fit pretty good. They don't offer half sizes, so if you wear an 11 and a half, you will probably want to get an 11. They don't run big. So if you wear 12 and a half, you'd get a 12. Mine are 12s, I believe. Oh, 12.5 is what it says. But I was, for some reason, I'm thinking that they don't offer half sizes. So if I'm wrong, you know, make the correction. But I'm thinking for some reason they don't offer half sizes. But for, you know, like I said, those Red Wing boots that I have are lasting me just fine. And I'm much heavier on the boot in the summertime than I am in the wintertime. Okay? Because we're just a lot more going on with fencing and the activities on the farm. The boot, you know, is comfortable, you know, and it's a neat, concept. They should put a kick plate over the toe of the boot. Okay. That would probably help out, which I noticed that the Baffin does. So I was going to review my Baffin boots with this boot and then do a comparison, cause I've been wearing my new Baffins for a little bit, but I got the Selkirks. The Baffin Selkirk is more of a snow, like the old moon boot, if you will. You know, it's a real full boot, okay? So I'm not going to compare those boots to these boots. What I'm going to do is, later on, I'm going to order some Baffin boots that are similar to the Muck boot, and then go over the product design of those, and then let you know also how they hold up. I will also say, too, that the liner of this Muck boot is really giving way. It's like there's creases and folds inside of it. The fabric inside is really stretching, and you know, it's just not holding up very well. Okay, so I don't want to spend that kind of money every single year after just a few months of use, 5 months of use, 4 months of use on a boot. I want to buy a boot and then have it for, you know, several years. Okay, because I like a good quality boot, and I'm not afraid to spend the money on the boot. Okay. And then also, just a plug for online shoes, if you go to onlineshoes.com, there are some of the lowest prices that I found on items, you know, shoe items. I got my Baffins, or list price on the Baffin website for $204, $205, over $200. And I got them on the online shoes with a 40% coupon for the holidays, whatever, for the end of the year sale. And I was able to pick those boots up for like $140. Okay, so online shoes, a shout out to them. Great customer service. They let you know when the boots come in. You could track your package. So I called them one time and asked them a question. They were courteous on the phone. So I would do more business with online shoes. So this is just a quick review on the Muck boots, the Muck boots Arctic Sport, and just showing you some of the failures of the boot after 1 year of use on the farm. And again, I would recommend maybe trying the Baffin style boot that's similar to this style boot, or maybe try a Muck boot. But like I said, if you're wearing them heavy and you're working hard, it's just a I don't in my opinion, it's not a boot that's going to hold up to the test, okay? Unless you want to buy new boots every single year. So this is Doug growing a Faith Farm with my Muck boots Arctic Sport review. And later on, maybe I'll post a video about my Baffin Selkirks. And I've been wearing those around the farm already. It's been, 20 degrees, 19 degrees here, muddy and wet, freeze and thaw. And I've been wearing those out, and I'll give a review on those. Thanks for watching. If you don't subscribe to our channel, please subscribe to our channel. And we appreciate you watching. And take care. Shalom.